proud principal of the School of Engineering and Arts. Thank you all for coming today to celebrate accomplishments moving on to middle school. We're very proud of our fifth grade students, as I know you are as well. I want to begin by thanking the Golden Valley Police Department. Their partnership is extremely important for our school and our entire community, so thank you very much. I'm happy to introduce Officer Matt Belter.
Good afternoon, parents. Thank you very much for everybody coming and obviously showing your support as we should, as our fifth graders move on to the next level of sixth grade. I'm sorry, of course, my voice is gone for some reason today. Trying to get over the allergies, like what's going on right now. So. It's one of the main things, like I say, I'm happy that you can all make it. That's one of the things I try to stress and counteract, obviously besides the drugs, alcohol, and violence, is the importance of them going over the assignments and talking with their parents about anything in life in general. Okay? It's important for me, and it should be important for them, that they know that they can go to you guys and talk to you guys about anything in life. That's important that you have that connection. As I had them go over their counteract books with you guys and had them sign each page of assignment that we did. Because as I told them, I want them to be comfortable in knowing that they can go to you guys for any questions about drugs, alcohol, and violence, or any questions about anything in general. That they know that they can go to you guys for the support and that you guys can talk to them about those situations. That is very important. Also, obviously, with the heroin epidemic right now, heroin is the number one killer of anything right now. People are dying almost by the second because of it. There's also the thing, like we've talked about in class, that they mix with the heroin called fentanyl. And then there's another thing, even stronger than fentanyl, which is what they mix with the heroin that can lead to obviously people getting hurt and officers getting hurt as they deal with that situation. So, it was another good year. I love being here with the fifth graders every week as we go over the counteract book. We're working on a more of an updated slide. So basically every time I come to class, I try to bring current events that are in the news and sports athletes, actors, actresses, other people are getting tied into the drug problem, the alcohol problem, and then try to, obviously let the fifth graders know that there's ways around that and there's ways of getting help and talking to you again about the importance of how all those things affect your body mentally and physically. So, thanks again, you guys. I won't talk anymore because I know I'm sort of annoying on this. So, thank you very much again for coming, you guys. It does mean a lot. So, thanks.
I'll bring the microphone way down. There's kind of a height difference between myself. We are so excited to have our students celebrated today on their work with Counteract. Officer Belter, like Officer Belter said, came and did wonderful lessons on just preparing our students for the future. I mean, this is our future, correct? Yes, yeah, let's give them a round of applause. And I wish nothing but the best for them. Definitely is a partnership, and we appreciate our parents coming today. Don't miss students. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you, Jim. And without further ado, our students have prepared a beautiful song for you, led by Mrs. Freeman.
Salad Morocco. I'm 11 years old. I'm in fifth grade at the School of Engineering Arts. I have a sister named Vanessa. She's 16 and she goes to Arts Art High School. I like to dance, sing, and read. My future goal is to go to a good college and have a good job. I want to go to a good college because if I do, then I can have a good job. I don't know which job I want in the future yet, but I know that I want a good paying job. Check it out. Say that you're with your friends at the mall. As you and your friends walk out of the mall, you see some guys about your age injecting heroin into their body with a syringe. The guys see you looking at them and ask you and your friends to join them. Your friends agree to join them. What would you do if you were in this situation? Would you A, join them, B, refuse and leave, or C, run away and call the police? Negative consequences. By doing some research, I found out that if you are caught using, selling, or manufacturing heroin, you will be arrested. If you have possession of heroin, you can spend 7 years in jail or have a $15,000 fine. However, if you are a dealer in heroin with intent to sell, you can spend anywhere from 5 years to a lifetime in jail or a $25,000 fine. You would also get a mark on your criminal record. One of the times, Officer Belter came in to counteract us, talked to us about heroin and the health consequences of heroin. Some other negative consequences are being grounded by your family for disobeying them, and going to jail or juvie. That depends on your age, though, and worst of all, death. Positive alternative. Some positive alternatives of saying no to the guise of heroin are being safe because heroin is really bad for you. Another positive alternative is not getting in trouble, because if you did do heroin or pretty much any drug, you could get in trouble with your family, police, teachers, or the law. Follow through. Even if your friends choose not to join you, make some new friends. Don't be their friends anymore. That's because they are bad friends for not listening to you. They are also bad influences. In conclusion, if I were in that position, I would have chosen C, run away and call the police. I would have chosen C because I wouldn't want to say no. I wouldn't wait for my friends to call me either because I wouldn't want to be friends with them because they are bad influences. I think that counteract will help me reach my future goals of going to a good college and having a good job.
Thank you. and I attend C, the School of Engineering and Arts. I'm 11 years old. I play basketball for Armstrong Bloomberg and soccer for Park Valley United. I have two older sisters and we live in Golden Valley, Minnesota. I love to read. When I grow up, I want to be a vet or own my own bakery. I would also want to be a professional athlete and maybe be in the Olympics. I love to hang out with my family and watch my sisters play their sports. I enjoy going on family vacations and going to visit to going to Wisconsin to visit with my extended family. I'm glad to be learning about the world around me and I hope that I can stay healthy and grow to follow my goals. Still, when being a child in fifth grade, more responsibilities tend to appear. A scenario that a child in your friend could be in is if you're walking to the park and you pass a kid who seems a lot older than you, is smoking, and suddenly he starts to follow you. As you arrive at the park and he is on the bench, soon ask you and your friend if you wanted to smoke. How can you help yourself and your friend? You can go through four steps by first talking to him and getting a feel for what kind of person he is by also checking out the problem. You can check it out more by looking at him and the cigarette. You can also check it out by using your prior knowledge of counteract and thinking about what it would do and for you. The next step is to figure out the consequences of what would happen if you did say yes. You can get into lots of trouble from your family and the police if they find out. Your lungs may not be able to take it, causing you to get sick. Your other friends may not talk to you anymore because of your wrong choices. You may realize that you made a mistake and you wish you could change it. Your mom and your friends may not let you see each other anymore, causing her not to trust you to welcome you home anymore. There are lots of consequences and can go on and on. After thinking about the first two steps, you're also going to think about positive alternatives. In this scenario, you might not think of any positive alternatives, but there may or may not be anything good about it. You may be able to learn something from this experience, like if you said yes to the boy and your parents found out, then you may realize that you should not have done it, making you realize how careful your decision should be. Another positive alternative is if you say no and follow through with the four steps, you can get out of the situation and you learn how to deal with peer pressure. There are lots of different ways that may help you make your decision, but you have to think long and hard about what decision is best for you. This is the final step that you should think about during the scenario. This step is to follow through. So you need to choose the right choice and maybe call the police, or annoy a boy and say no when you need. If your friend decides that she wants to stay and not make the right decision, then you need to take care of yourself and then maybe your friend will learn her lesson. Don't make your decision based on your friend. You want to make sure you can stick up for yourself so you can stay healthy by making the correct choice. These four steps can help you in this scenario because you may be tempted to say yes to things that are not good. It is also important that you don't talk to strangers. These steps can also help you recognize peer pressure and when you need to say no. The information I learned from counteract will help me reach my goals by letting me know it is not good to get into drugs, alcohol, or smoking. Helping me live a happy and healthy lifestyle.
Our students are going to go out for a little bit and they will be coming back to receive their certificate. Moving on, certificate and a counteract certificate. So thank you for the patience as they exit. Get your cameras ready because they will individually be coming back in. Also, there'll be a photo opportunity, of course, after our ceremony.
Valley's class. First up, we have Andrea Adams. James Berger. Kevin Colorado Valero. Kaya Dablin. Amy Edlin. Mackenzie Ernst. David Fromby. Jack Grusner. Grace Hankey. Chase Haugen. Wes Hamilchek Spindler. Arvin Mee. Phoenix Nine. Lizzie Naheem. Pearl Ofer-Gison. Ava Olson. Jada Parker. Savannah Subendran. Isabel Dole. Rowan Tierney. Chris Virgin Palmiers. Nora Vladimirova. Connor Watkins. Avery Wolf. Congratulations, room 222.
Class, room 220.
Elsa Amarco. Jaden Bartel. Bella Boca. Christopher Callen. Julia Brusner. Peter Hansman. Ty Haraldson. Damian Hatcher. Gabrielle Hillerin Halsey. Zia Izulamani. Calvin Critch. Katie Lear. Kaden Morrow. Isabel Nguyen. Audrey Peterson. Noah Kwan. Claire Riesenberg. Cassidy Rory. Blessing Sacky. AJ Scott. Maggie Stassen. Stephanie Stognes. Sadiq Wibu. Bryn Winker. Bert Whitmers. And Leia Youngmark. Let's hear it one more time for Mr. Insta and Mr. Kelly.
Stop her up.
Galita Arba. Artiaga. Sadiq Blanchard.
at this time, the fifth graders would like to share a special video with our special guest.
Home. I'm in the middle of the city, making a sound.
think we know who you guys can thank for those cute baby pictures. One, we want to thank our families for coming today and sharing this special day, this moment. And fifth grade students, there's a message from myself and all the teachers and all the staff here at SEEP, and that is that you always have a home here. You always are welcome to come back and visit. And if you ever need anyone to talk to, I know you have your parents to speak to for advice as you're growing up, because from these baby pictures, we can tell that you grow up pretty quick. Please know that you can always come back, and any of the teachers and staff here are happy to help you whenever you need. But I know, just with the 2 short years that I've been a part of the School of Engineering Arts, you're an extraordinary group of students with some innovative ideas, smart-minded. I've always said we look good, we're smart, we're good-looking, we're talented, we got brains. This is a fabulous group of fifth graders. So 2024 graduates. The fifth grade teachers would like me, we should thank our fifth grade teachers. I want to thank Mr. Belling, Mrs. Duran, and Mrs. Anne. Thank you. We had so many parents that helped organize our fun day at the park and supported this graduation moving on ceremony. So thank you to those parents, Janet, Tammy, Barrett, Melanie, Ann and Chris, Allison and Kim Whitmers. Thank you to those parents that are here to help me. Kate, what's going to happen is our teachers, fifth grade, just so you know too, our teachers will be taking our students out first so you can join us for some cake. Fifth grade teachers would like to say please have your fifth grader parent check in with the teacher if he or she is going home early. So you're going to have cake, but please just connect with your teacher. I know you guys have already signed out, but let them know so we're not missing any kids. And boys and girls, Chromebooks, bags, and charging cords are due Monday. So your Chromebooks, bags, and charging cords are due Monday. They're exciting to socialize. Thank you, everybody. The teachers are going to take a kick.